Prepare for 3 days, which you'll end up with the first of all.
Well, I think the most important thing for us to get prepared to play this UTEP, to have the team of our size. They'll have sometimes a full 6'7", 6'8", 6'9", 6'10". With length, they'll play 2-2-1, back to a zone, they'll play 1-3-1, they'll do a lot of boxing one, so they'll do different things just to mix it up. So for us, the most important thing to prepare for the UTEP.
And Tim Floyd's a guy, you know, obviously he's been all over the place. What sort of is a couple of hallmarks about his getting ready to
play? Well, I think they're always physical. They play hard in the game. When I was a player at Purdue, we played them at New Orleans, they played a boxing one, they did different things defensively. I've seen them over the years, some of the same things.
A lot of basketball in a short period of time. How much do you think you're going to learn about your team when you return to Knoxville?
We've learned a lot thus far. I mean, to play a true role game against Xavier, and that is your first college game for most young guys. We found out a lot about our team from there. How to make adjustments, playing without Jordan Stokes early in the game. And you just kind of go from there. These talented teams, for us, it's just continue doing things we do in practice. We've had success in shooting the ball. We had to be able to go inside, outside. Utilize Jordan in a lot of situations, play off Jordan. Utilize our big guys around the rim, get offensive rebounds and defend.
Talk about Jordan, a nice honor for him today. Can you just talk about his game right now, what you're seeing from him?
Well, I mean, Jordan's playing well. You think about it, he could be averaging 25, 26 points a game right now. I think he's hovering around 22 a game. But very efficient, passing the ball, not forcing shots, going inside, outside, shooting a three-point shot. And again, he's gotten to the point that three-point shot is just almost, you know, one of the best in the country as far as a catch-and-shoot guy, but he's also a guy who can put on the floor, make plays off the dribble. He gets to the free throw line. He knows how to get fouled. He's doing a better job of moving without the ball, setting screens to get other guys' shots, and then attacking off the dribble.
When Antonio became available, what was it about his game, your experience with him, made you think he'd be the ideal fit here?
Well, I think the first thing was the level of toughness I thought he played with and watching him in scouting reports, and he was one of the guys that we really had to identify with him. And went through our scout reports on a guy that can make shots, really run in transition, but also a guy that can play the one and the two position. Runs in transition, but he's more off the ball then. So just a guy we feel like can help us with stretching the defense and making shots.
And two new point guards that are new to this team, you've been in single-digit turnovers a couple times now. How have y'all been able to kind of keep those turnovers low?
Well, I think it's more so a team thing and taking care of the basketball. Darius is the kind of guy, he's pushing, he's looking for the lob pass, he's looking to get guys, he's a pass for a type of guy. Antonio's a guy that makes shots, he's looking to shoot the ball. But I think as a team, we're doing a better job of taking care of the basketball. Our big guys got to be a little bit better than Jarnell and Jaron, but everybody else I think is in plus margin assist to turnover ratio.
How much zone have you faced and how did the team handle it?
I think we've done a good job against the zone. We're able to make shots and we got better movement, we're passing. We're attacking off the zone. And then again, with a zone, you got to be able to make shots. And I think the thing that helps us a lot is Darius and Antonio do a really good job of pass faking in the zone. And that's just as well as making a shot. You're able to pass fake and find your shooters, and it stretches things out for us.
Coach, you played a lot of players the past few games. How much will that help you down there, do you think, playing that many games?
I will see. As long as, you know, we have to go extend our bench, I mean, the guys have to be effective. And like Derek came in this morning, worked out at 11:30. Because you have to stay ready. I mean, Quentin Chivas comes in and work out, and those guys understand your number could be called at any given time. You have to be prepared, you have to be ready to go. And Derek's a guy that can play three or four positions for us, so you got to get him ready, got to get him locked in. If your number's called, you got to be ready to go.
Does it make it that much more important, though, with the tournament, back-to-back games, that kind of thing?
I think so, but again, those guys have to be ready to play and have to get productive minutes. I mean, just because you have, you know, 11, 12 guys, they still have to be productive.
Could you see any kind of particular benchmark for Jaron to be able to get through, you know, some 3 games in 3 days like this, or is it not something?
Again, one game at a time. We like to get him in and get him out. I kind of gauge, we monitor his minutes on the bench more so than anybody else, but it's also for me getting the feel for how he looks on the floor. And every time he comes out of the game, I'll ask him how he's feeling. Then if I see he's exhausted, even if he says he's not, I'll take him out of the game. But just so he can stay fresh and locked in, because part of his strength is his ability to play on both ends of the floor, to play hard, to defend, to rebound. And if he gets exhausted, we got to get him out of there to get him back in.